The new Xcode predictive code completions are a game changer for iOS developers, making coding faster and more intuitive than ever. By intelligently predicting your new lines of code based on context, they not only save time, but also reduce the chances of errors. In this video, I will show you how to unlock the full potential of this feature, streamlining your workflow and boosting productivity in your Swift UI projects. Whether you're a seasoned developer or just getting started, this guide will help you harness the power of Xcode's latest enhancement. Predictive code completion in Xcode 16 is amazing. It is the AI in Xcode that we finally got. And today I'm going to show you how you can enable it if you haven't already enabled it, and how to use it. So I have created here a demo project, predictive code completion. And first of all, what you need to know is that you have to be on Xcode 16, and also you have to be on macOS Sequoia, macOS 15. So that's the first thing that you have to know, and you have to download the code completion model. So that can be found. If you are just downloading Xcode 16, it will ask you to do so. But if you kind of skipped it or forgot to download it, then you can go under Xcode. So select Xcode and then settings. Let me just move this right over here, and then select components, and right over here you will either see predictive code completion model, or if not, then click on the plus sign and select it, and of course download it. It, you know, just download it as any other component like iOS 18 and all of that stuff. So how can you enable it? Because maybe if you just did not download it, you also need to enable it. Or if you want to disable it, here's how you can do that. So you can go under, again, Xcode settings, and then text editing. Just jump right over here and select editing. And you will see that here is that predictive code completion checkmark. So you may enable it or disable it at your will. We're going to enable it, of course. And now it's time to use it. So let me just have a little bit more space here for the code. And what I want to just demo right over here is some basic stuff. Why basic? Because with this you will learn how to actually use it. Now you can have a lot of fun with predictive code. Let's just see how it actually works. So basically there are two ways of how you can use predictive code in your Xcode project. The first one, and this might not be the obvious one to use, is to create a comment, and then the model will try to create some code or suggest some code for you. So yeah, as you can see, now we have a new line. This is different. We just added a new line and it's just suggested if debug, and you also saw that it takes a little while. Of course, yeah, this is a big thing. It takes a little while, so you have to be patient with it. So what we are going to do is create a profile struct, a model, and we're going to have maybe some name in it, and we are going to make it codable, create some coding keys, decoder, encoder, and then we are going to create an array of these profiles and then put them inside the list in Swift UI. So that should cover a lot of stuff that predictive code completion can do for us in Xcode 16. Swift UI Camp is the ultimate way to rapidly boost your Swift UI skills with an immersive hands-on learning experience condensed into just 4 weeks. You'll explore crucial topics like creating views, managing data, using Codable, and mastering navigation, all through engaging Zoom sessions. This bootcamp is crafted to fast-track your progress with real-time support and practical projects, equipping you to become a Swift UI expert quickly. Don't miss out. Click the link in the description for more details. So, let's create some a comment here. So, basically think of it like you would create a comment for an existing code. So, it would be something like this. And sometimes it does not work, sometimes it works. Let's see how it turns out. And hit the return. So let's see what it's going to suggest. Yeah, it's suggesting the if debug again. Let's hit ask for another try at it, or let's hit a return again. Yeah, it's a really, really annoying when, you know, it's not getting to what you're actually trying to do. So in this case, it's good that, you know, we are having troubles. It's a tutorial. So in this case, what I like to do is just start typing it out. So let's have a struct. And it's still not, you know, don't want predictive code completion test. So struct. And let's type out profile. Let's see. As you can see now, it's kind of getting the hang of it. And by the way, as your project gets bigger and bigger, it has that context of the file system it has. So it's getting better and better of what it's going to suggest. So now we see, you can see we have codable and identifiable. Now, how can we select this choice that it's been presented to us? Well, it's you just need to hit tab. And then, and now we can see it just added two more suggestions. An ID, that's fine, and the name. Now, actually, I want to be this name to be a variable because maybe I want to change it. No, that's my preference right over here. But let for now is also okay. So I hit tab again, and it added those two new lines. And that's great. So let's see what we have over here. Yeah, let's fix that, make it a variable, and also a variable right over here for the name. Great, this is kind of amazing. As you can see, you just need to give it a little push, a little bit of context. Okay, so yeah, let's create the coding keys. It's codable, it just automatically assumes that it will have some coding keys. Let's do that. Case name, that's fine. And basically that's it, because the ID, of course, has already a set up value, the UUID. Great. So now let's hit two more returns right over here. And it's suggesting the custom initializer of the name. And actually, it's a good thing that it's suggesting the initializer, because I really like custom initializers. And we are going to see that in just a second. So let's have that with the name. I just hit return, and then it's just suggesting again the self.name equals name. Let's hit return on that too. So great. Let's hit two more new lines, and now it should suggest, yes, it did, the decoder. Of course, this is really, really like basic stuff. It should suggest the decoder, and really flattering that it's doing its thing. It's really great. So let's hit tab. And then, the container looks okay, and the decoder, decoding on the container looks fine. So I just hit return the tab key two times. And of course, we also need the encoder. Now, I found that it's not usually giving me this automatically. And as you can see, we just waited a few seconds and it did not. But if I just type out function, yes, it's suggesting the encode to encoder. And it looks okay. And as you can see, I'm just scanning the suggested code to make sure that it is actually what I want. Sometimes it's not exactly what I want, but I choose to add it because, you know, I just added two lines of code, which would take a lot of time to type in. And then I know what to change, like we did with the variable type of the name. So, yeah. This is actually what I want in the profile. It's kind of sad that it did not suggest the actual struct with the comments. And actually, I found this to be not that reliable. Most probably, we are going to get a lot of updates, and it should be. But inline code completion really, really shines right over here. Okay. So let me just have a little bit more space over here. I should actually added this a few minutes ago, but now we have it over here. So the plan is to have a list of some profiles. So first of all, I just want to have a state variable with the profiles array. So let's just start out state, And let's see what we are having here. No, that's not the text. So I'm just going to type out state. And one more thing, you have to get accustomed to this. In previous versions of Xcode, you might hit tab over here and you just use the code completion, not the predictive one, but the code completion or return. So you have to know that from now on, code completion, simple code completion, hit return, just like that. Otherwise, if you already have a predictive code completion, you may choose tab. Okay, var, and let's just have profiles. And let's see if it's just guessing it. Yes, so it's plural. It knows that we need an array of profile. That's fine. So I hit return over there. Now, in this demo, I just want to have some default values right over here. So I hit return right over here. And let's see if it's suggesting. Not just yet, but let's just hit a dot right over here. And as you can see, just having init from, that's not actually what we need. So I just go right over here. And you see the predictive code completion also suggests the new value. And of course, it's just going to suggest the project owner at first. So let's hit tab over there. Let's hit another return. And now it's just suggesting John Doe. That's fine. Let's hit another one. Jane Smith, great. And I think that's you get a point over here, and we have a nice array of those profiles. Next up, I want to create a list. So now we just had, the models and then some data population. And now let's see how it handles Swift UI. So let me just remove all of this and start typing out list. So yeah, just suggesting the list, hit tab over there. And really, really nice. So it just have the for each profiles. It recognizes that the profile model is an identifiable, so it's not suggesting to set an ID. And it also recognizes that the profile has a name property, so it just puts it nicely into this text. And yeah, actually, this is what I wanted. And of course, this took a lot of time because now I'm explaining all of this stuff. But it does actually make our lives easier because of suggesting stuff to us. And as the more we use it in our project, the better it gets because it gets a more context on our project. We have a lot more code in our project. It knows a lot more. And it saves on time because you just hit a few tabs and maybe you do some changes. It does. So inline code completion works really well. And yeah, finally, let's do this as a last note right over here. Let's hit return right over here. And it's just suggesting something on appear because usually on the cells, we want to do some on appears. But please know that if this text would be, let's say, inside a VStack, it would suggest something else, usually a font or a padding. So it's really, really smart. I just want to have a font right over here. So dot and type in F. And there we go. We have the suggestion of headline. And that's it. That's how easy it is to use predictive code completion in Xcode 16. And I will see you in the next one.